It was mentioned that when earth is stable, or when our earth element is stable, then we can perceive a distinct sun and moon phases. Or if earth is rotating stable, then one half is daytime, other half is nighttime. If earth is wobbling, then the cycle is disturbed. So in the context of attention deficiency disorder, let us return to the role of earth element and its influence on the fire element of the personality. When we are confined to our room for major proportion of our time, depending on the harmony state of the five elements in the room, our earth element gets altered or gets influenced. If the harmony state of external five elements in the room is disturbed, the internal confluence of solar and lunar union of violet radiation leaks out. Or in other words, through the harmony state of external five elements, one can enrich the internal violet radiation, because it's bidirectional. If there is a leaking path, it will leak out, and if there is a path to enrich it, it will get enriched. So when this twilight radiation finds a path to leak out, followed by the disturbance in the five elements, that process will affect the earth element. Since fire element is adjacent to earth element, it bears the brunt of this disharmony. When an individual is confined to the room and his violet radiation is dried up, the earth element wobbles. The vessel of personality drains all its energy in an effort to restore balance and perform the acts of impatience, anger, mood swing, fidgeting, attempting multitasking, all these with no success. The luck factor also doesn't cooperate in this situation. This is the secret of this universe. When in harmony, one can draw and concentrate as much energy spectrum as possible, but in a state of disharmony, the individual becomes a convenient medium to give away all that he has. Our sages used to meditate in naturally formed caves, known as guha. These are enclosures in high altitude mountains or in some locations underground regions. Guha means the concentration of Jupiter magnetic energy drawing the light into the enclosure of cave. Such a natural setting is perfect platform to reset the faculties and extending the limits of confluence solar and lunar radiation to infinity. And of course, enlightenment can also happen in this situation. Here, they can concentrate for ages without any disturbance, and they survive by expending minimum energy, sometimes even no energy, because their senses cooperate. Then senses operate in the confluence of solar lunar radiation forever. In a way, the senses and faculties merge into the soul. A man-made house is not a substitute for naturally formed cave. However, if we can replicate the environmental conditions of naturally formed cave, one can overcome any number of deficiencies. In Valmiki Ramayana, the Sach team that are southbound sent on a mission in search of Sita by Sugriva, the king of chimps. They enter the vast cave located underground It is known as Bila. This incident on the hidden secrets were beautifully described by Valmiki in his epic Ramayana. Eventually, the chimps emerge out from this cave with their faculty of discretion being reset, replenished, and qualifying them to be successful in their mission. But generally speaking, it is harder to meditate in a cave that is underground because it's difficult to focus universal cosmic energy into underground cave. The magnetic waves from Jupiter diverge upon reaching that surface. If there is a way to concentrate these magnetic waves, the underground cave will fetch much more dividends than a high altitude cave. In Netherlands, there was a famous limestone caves in Maastricht, place called Maastricht. Centuries ago, people entered these caves, lost their way out, and turned lunatic. However, naturally formed diamonds, gemstones, quartz crystals, and the pearls that are found in ocean beds, they seem to know the technique of harnessing universal cosmic energy. Perhaps keeping these items in the living room may promote the confluence of lunar and solar energies and may help the individual to overcome ADD or attention deficiency disorder. But caution must be attached to these, as these items may need replenishment from time to time. The Kohinoor diamond, the largest in the world, it was drawing all the attention from the world in India, and subsequently now it is drawing the attention in UK because of the same reason that it is able to concentrate so much of cosmic energy in it. Welcome to the 183rd episode of Lalita Divya Rahasya Sastra Nama Stotra. Next Nama is Shivapriya. The 8th generation human faculties of discretion and personality getting activated. In the Rama Shivankari, the faculty of intellect activated, while Shivapriya facilitated the activation of discretion and personality of 8th generation human. Panchabrahma, fire and air elements, Narayana, earth element, have entered into the baby through the capillary tube connection. Hence, the Sivasakta Samarasya, harmony of northbound and southbound forces in the body, helped towards the activation of faculties of discretion and personality. Therefore, 8th generation human faculties of intellect, discretion and personality were activated while he or she was still in the womb. In the case of 7th generation human, their faculties were activated after birth as part of the training imparted by Panchabrahma and Maheshwara entities. This was explained in Shadanga Devata Yukta Shadgunya Paripurita. The 8th generation soul is more evolved, and hence the faculties were activated in the womb. This meant the universe is marching forward. That is the strategy of the Universal Mother. Through the Nama Shivapriya, Nishprapanchari and this planet Earth. Next Nama is Shivapara. The 8th generation human receiving Panchabrahma training. Para is the fragmented or breakaway energy from the harmony state of Shivasakta Samarasya. This fragmented energy consisting of earth element of Narayani in tight bondage or tight bonding of Pancha Brahma. In the Nama, Shivapriya, Pancha Brahma Narayani harmony energy manifested. In the 8th generation human, the breakaway energy from this harmony state is Shivapara. In this universe, there are three forms of Vasikarana or mesmerizing techniques. Sometimes these are also called seduction techniques. These are Para, Apara and Para, Para. Among these, the 8th generation human receiving the Paravasikarna Vidya training is Shivapara. So one must learn Vasikarna Vidya technique from the witness or neutral element, then only it will be effective. This training is as much for the baby as to the mother, preparing her for motherhood, imbibing the qualities of unconditional compassion in her. Through the Nama, Shivapara, Nirashtraya re-understanded. Next Nama is Sistesta. The training of Ardha Shodasha Vidya given to 8th generation human while he was still in the womb. Through the Nama, Namas, Shivankari, Shivapriya and Shivapara, a total of 8 virtues have entered into the 8th generation human in the womb. Turning this into a package of Ardha Shodasha Vidya, the Pancha Brahma that have entered into 8th generation human uses this package as Ardha Shodasha Vidya to train the baby. This training is administered in the womb. It was mentioned in Bhagavata that Narada administered training to Prahlada while he was still in the womb. Similar thing happened to Subhadra, the wife of the consort of Arjuna, while she was carrying Abhimanyu. Krishna explains about Padmavyuha, the intricate arrangement of army barrier that enemy once enters, there's only one exit. The enemy who dares to enter Padmavyuha has only two choices: to find the single exit and then be alive or perish. While Krishna was explaining to Subhadra about the strategy of Padmavyuha, Abhimanyu also grasped this information. It may be possible in both occasions Shodasha Vidya techniques were being used. The fire element of Pancha Brahma. Sha means the Shushumna Nadi, or tiny capillary tube of Shushumna Nadi. Ashta are 8 virtues. These are 3 nadis of Ida, Pingala and Shushumna, 3 faculties and 2 Pancha Brahma elements. It seems the training of Ardha Shodasha Vidya was administered based on the fire element as medium of fire element of Pancha Brahma as the medium. Such a training is Sistesta. Through the Nama, Sistesta, Nichisuddha, re-enters planet Earth. In Bharata, Swasva Varnasramai Dharmai Dharmaimya Bhagavad Darpitai Yatpujanam Natad Gandha Malyadinam Samarpanai Acharya Prabhuo Dharmo Dharmasya Prabhurachyuta. In Vasishta Sutra, Napani Pada Chapalo Sanetra Palo Bhavet Nachava Ganga Chapala Iti Sistasya Gochara Param Parya Gato Yesham Vedas Sapari Brahmana तेसिष्टा ब्रह्माणाग्नेयः श्रुति प्रत्यक्षहेतवः. Remaining namas we'll explore in the next episode. Thank you.